people tend to do this weird thing when they meet a dog. We call them strange names like Sweetie Face and ask them if they know they're so cute in that odd, slow tempo, higher pitched speech pattern we also use with babies. It's actually a real thing called pet directed speech, or PDS, and a lot of us do it. I know I do. I talk to Pete differently when I'm leaving than I do when we're hanging out cuddling, but he's a cat, so it's moot. But I do wonder if he notices or cares, and likewise if dogs care about how their owners talk to them. A study looked at how owners talk to their dogs, specifically female owners. In this study, 34 adult women were recorded interacting with their dogs in 4 instances: before being separated, reuniting after said separation, playing, and giving commands. They found the intricacies of PDS changed. The women used a lower pitch before separation, a high pitch upon reuniting, a questioning tone during play, and imperatives in giving commands coupled with attention-getting measures. Female owners, the study found, adapt their verbal cues to the situation, giving their pet hints about their intentions and emotions. But does this really mean that pets care about the tone of your voice? Maybe not. Another study recorded women delivering a set line. Hi, hello cutie, who's a good boy? Come here, good boy, yes, come here sweetie pie, what a good boy. To pictures of puppies, adult dogs, and old dogs, then analyzed the quality of their speech to find that people use a higher pitch with puppies. The recordings were then played back to dogs alongside normal speech to gauge reactions. The researchers found that puppies reacted more to dog-directed speech, specifically that higher pitch got their attention, whereas older dogs didn't really react more strongly to one tone over another. Older dogs, the researchers found, were more responsive to a familiar voice. Another study adds to this. The researchers videoed 44 adult pet dogs and 19 puppies listening to a voice recording of a set phrase announced in either adult-directed speech, pet-directed speech, or infant-directed speech. They were looking for gaze as a measure of the dog's attention and reaction to the voice recordings. In this study, the adult dogs showed more responsiveness than puppies to pet than adult-directed speech. So we've got conflicting studies. What's actually going on here? Well, it's difficult to really know without further research, but there might be more to it than just speech patterns. Dogs specifically are more in tune to human body language than most animals, about the level of an infant, which might be why humans started domesticating them in the first place. And many owners feel their bond with a pet is as strong as that with any human companion. So maybe it all comes down to the bond we have with our own pets. While puppies are excited by anything and everything new, the older dog's responsiveness to a familiar voice does suggest that it's an owner-related reaction more than anything. But hey, that won't stop me from using a weird voice when I talk to Pete. So that's dogs in language, but what about humans in language? We looked into how bilingual brains perceive time in this episode right here. What weird ways do you talk to your pets? Let us know in the comments, give this video a like, and be sure to subscribe so you never miss an episode of Seeker.